Now let's talk about the Return Address Stack Predictor, or RAS. We have seen that there are several types of branches that we need to predict. For conditional branches, we need to predict the direction. Is it taken or not? And by now we have seen a number of predictors that predict direction reasonably well for these types of things. If this branch is taken, we will need to also predict the target address, and for that, a simple BTB that just remembers the previous target when the branch was taken will do just fine because we always have the same target. Another type of branches are unconditional jumps, function calls, etc. As far as their direction is concerned, it's trivial, they are always taken. So even the simplest predictor of the direction predictor type will do well on these. As far as the target prediction is concerned, most of these either jump to a label or call a specific function. So a simple BTB that just remembers the previous target when this instruction was executed will do just fine. So it looks like we have handled both the direction and the target for most of the common branch types. However, there is a type of branch, specifically the function returns, which is always taken, so the direction prediction will do just fine. But the target is often difficult to predict. If this function is always called from the same place, then the return will always jump back to the same location, and in that case the BTB will do fine. But usually we create a function so that it can be called from multiple places in the program. Something like this. We have an instruction that can call this function. Somewhere else in the program, we have another instruction that can call the same function. This function has a return instruction, and now the problem is that this return instruction should either jump here or here, depending on where it was called from. The BTB in this case will not do too well. Why? Well, because when we call this and return here, the BTB will remember that this is the target address. Then we reach this point, call again, return. We should be returning here, but the BTB is predicting this. So we have a misprediction. The BTB now will learn that this is the correct target. Next, we come back to this code again, and again, the BTB is predicting here while we should be returning here, and then again and again, so it never predicts correctly. So the question is, how can we predict returns accurately?